Hello students, as you are observing, we are going to discuss cube and cube root in this video. Hope you are able to understand the concept of square and square root, finding the square root by using two different method, that is your prime factorization and your long division method. In this video, we will discuss cube and cube root. So let's start. What is cube? If we multiply a number with itself three times, so what output we receive is known as your cube of the given number. Cube of the given number. So here we can write down this 125 is equals to cube of 5, and cube of 5 represented by symbol of power 3. So this is the concept of cube. Next one is your perfect cube. So perfect cube is same as cube. Perfect cube is same as perfect square, not cube. Perfect square means what? A natural number. A natural number that like 125 or like your 8, which is expressed as a cube of another natural number. So this type of natural number is known as your perfect cube. In this case, 8 itself is a perfect cube because we can express 8 as a cube of 2. So this is the concept of your perfect cube. Then we have some properties in case of cube, and these are very important. All of you must keep in mind that cube of odd numbers is always odd. And similarly, cube of even number is also even. This explains by, from the example, cube of 5, that is odd number, is odd. Cube of even number is also even. Now next one is about sign. Suppose we are going to find out the cube of minus 2. This is not natural number, but if we are going to find out minus 2, so remember sign is same. In case of finding any cube, sign never change. In case of square, if we find out the square of minus 2, sign changes. But in case of cube, sign never changes. So this gives you the cube, it's a minus 8. So minus 8 is a cube of minus 2. And remember, these are not natural numbers. Clear? Now, about cube root. As we know that cube of 3, cube of 3 is 27. So from here we can write down cube of 3 is 27. So this is this statement in form of cube. Now, as I told you that we are going to discuss about cube root. Remember, cube root means what? That cube number is cube of which number? So this statement also written as cube root of 27 is 3. As we know that in case of square we use this symbol for writing the square root, but in case of cube root we use one more thing, that is your 3. So cube root of 27 is cube root of 3 into 3 into 3. Here we are going to remove the cube root by taking the combination of 3 same type, taking the multiples of 3 same type of number. So in this case we can write down this. So this completes the statement of this one. So cube root of 27 is 3. This is the statement, or this is the concept of cube root. Remember, sign never changes. I will discuss how we find out the negative cube root or cube root of a negative number. So while discussing the problems given in your book, so let's start to discuss or solve some questions given in this book. Before we discuss the problems given in book, I'm going to explain you how we find the cube root. Suppose I am taking one number 512. How we find the cube root? So finding the cube root is very easy. You have to find out first prime factors. So it's a 2 2 4 2 5 10, 2 6, then it's a 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, and 2. So these are the prime factors. After this, we can write down 512 equals to how many 2s are there? 3, 3, 6, 3, 9. But we are going to find out the cube root of 512. What does it mean? We have to use this symbol. We have to use this symbol. Remember, this cap is moves to the complete factors. Now we make the combination 3, 3, and 3. So for removing this cube root, for each combination we use one number. There are 3, so it's a 8. So cube root of 512 is 8. Likewise, you have to find out while solving the sum. So let's start to solve the sum given in your exercise. Now let's start to find out cube of some given number. Here I am going to find out the cube of fraction, because all of you know how to find out simple natural numbers. So cube of 2 upon 3, in this case we have to find separately cube of numerator by cube of denominator. And this, in this case, we can write down 2 into 2 into 2 by 3 into 3 into 3. It's a 8 upon 27. Likewise, you have to find out all the numerator, all the cube of fraction. One more I have to discuss with you. We have to find out cube of minus 6 upon 7. So in this case we can write down, here we have minus sign. So remember, you have to use minus sign for numerator only, for the sake of uniformity. It's a cube, So here we can write down minus 6 into minus 6 into minus 6. Similarly, see over here, 7 into 7 into 7. So remember, minus minus plus minus minus. Already minus sign we have to write down minus sign. 6, 6 are 36. 36, 6 are 216. 6, 6 are 36, 3 carry, 6, 3 are 18, 3, 21, 216, 7, 7 are 49, 49, 7 are, let's calculate, 7, 9 are 63, 6 carry, 7, 4 are 28, 28 plus 6, it's a 3, 4, 3. So this is the, likewise, we have to solve or find out cube of the given number. Let's discuss finding the cube of some decimal numbers. Let's take one decimal number, that is 2.5. We are going to find out the cube of this. For finding this, we can use two ways. Either we can multiply directly the given decimal number, or we can convert this in rational number first, then find out the cube. So here we can write down directly 25 into 25 into 25 for numerator, and for denominator 10 into 10 into 10. So we can see here 25 into 25, 625, and again we have 25. 10 into 100, 1000. It's a 1000. So we can multiply this in rough 25, 625. 25 5s are 125. 12 carry, 25 2s are 50, plus 12, 62. 6 carry, 25 6s are 150. 150 plus 6, 156. So here we can write down 15625 divided by 10,000. We can convert again this in decimal, so 15.625. So this is the cube of this given decimal number. If this decimal number is of minus sign, then we have to place minus sign in this case, and then at every place, like I'll discuss with you in rational number. So hope this one is clear to you. Move to the next question. Next question is, question says that write the cubes of multiples of 3 between 20 and 30. Question is cubes of multiples of 3 between, it's a, what is between 20 and 30. So see how many numbers are there between 20 and 30. One is your 21, 24, 27 and 30. 30 is not required. So we have to find out cube of 21, that is 21 into 21 into 21. We have to find out cube of 24, that is 24 into 24 into 24. And then we have to find out cube of 27. It's a 27 into 27 into 27. So we have to find out by multiplying these numbers. So I give the hint for this question, all of you try to solve by yourself. Now next question is finding the cube root of the given numbers. Here I am going to find out cube root of 2197. How we find, as we already discussed, we use prime factorization method. So see, here first we do the prime factorization method at the int 7. So this is divisible by 3 first, 3 7 ja, 3 3 ja. No, it's not divisible by 3. So check whether it's divisible by 7 or not. 7 3s are 21. 7 1 is 7. 7, it's not divisible by 7 also. So we have to check it. It's not divisible by 3, not 5, 7. It, since here is an odd number, so we have to check by 9. No, it's not divisible. If 3 is not divide this, and then 9 also not divide. We'll check by 11. 11, 1 is 11. It's 11 is also not divisible because 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Difference is not 0. So we'll take check by 3. It's a 2, 1, 9, 7. 13, 1 is 13. And 39 ja 117. So it's a 13. So 13 is a 169. 13, it's a 13. So we can say 2197 is equals to 13 into 13. So but we have to find out cube root. So cube root of this is this. This is a complete pair. So for removing the cube root sign, we can write 13 only. So this is the cube root of 2197. Check the next question. I am going to solve. Find out. Question says that find out the cube root of this number -1331. So in this case, first we have to find out the prime factors of 1331. Remember this: 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, 3 7 21. So 3 4s are 12, 13 is there. 3 4s are 12. Sorry, it's not divisible by 3. We can check it by 7. 7 1 is 7, 43 7, 6 is 42, not. Check it by 11. 3 1 4, 3 1 4. It's, I think it's 11. 11 1 is 11, 11 2 is 11, 11 1 is. It's 11, 11. Now, here we are going to find out the cube root of 1331. But first we have to write down 1331 equals to 11 into 11 into 11. Cube root of -1331 is equals to minus cube root of 1331. And now we can write down cube root of 1331 is 11 into 11 into 11. Ultimately we can write down -11. So hope this one is clear to you. Likewise, you have to find out the cube root of any negative number. Next question says that find out the cube root of multiple minus this multiplication. In this case, many of you first try to find out the product of these two, then you find out the your cube root. But in this question, there is a trick. There is multiple sign. So first we find out the cube root factors of 216, then factor of 343, cube root, and we can then multiply on at last. So what is the factor of 216? Prime factors. It's a 108, 54, 27. Now it says 3 9 ja and 3 3 ja. This is for 216. What about 343? It's a 3. check about 7. Yes, it's a 7. So now here we can write, we are going to find out the, now in after this you can write down, we are going to find out the cube root of minus 216 into 343. So we can take, remove the minus sign outside, cube root of 216 into 343. As we know, the prime factors of 216 are 3, 2, 3, 3. Similarly, factors of 343 are 37. So write down, use a cap above all. Now make the combination of three numbers, three identical numbers. So it's a minus 2 into 3 into 7. Use bracket. It's a minus 7, 3 is a 21, 21, 2 is a 42. It's a 42. So likewise, you have to find out the cube root of any product. Now, next types are finding the cube root of decimal number or rational number. Here, I am going to find out the cube root of decimal number, and by using this, you can also understand how to find out the rational number. So, we can write down 0.216 as we are going to find out the cube root of 0.216, or we can write this number as in form of rational number. Now, we have to find out the cube root of this. For finding cube root, we have to find the cube root of numerator and denominator separately. It's a clear. And similarly, about 1000. We can write it as directly 10, but I'm explaining this to you. Clear? Now, in next page, we can write down, we have to find out the cube root of 0.216. So we can write down cube root of 216 upon 1000. Now write down the prime factors of both 216 and 1000. It's a 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Hope this one is clear. Now about 10,000. Sorry, 1000, not 10,000. Now, for removing, we can write down 2 into 3, 2 into 5, it's a 6 upon 10. Now convert it into decimal number, it's a 0.6. Hope this one is clear to you. Likewise, you have to find out all the rational numbers, all the cube roots of the rational or decimal numbers. Now move to the next question. I am solving only one question of this type. And another type of question is homework for you. I will tell you which question is for your homework. This question says that find the smallest number by which 2916 should be divided. 2916 should be divided to make a perfect cube number. To show that quotient is a perfect cube. So that, remember, it's a quotient is perfect cube.
ना?
For this, what we have to find out? First, we have to find out the prime factors of this number, and then we'll try to solve. This is almost same type of question what we did in square and square root. So let's start. It's a 2, 9, 1, 6. See, 3, 3, 3, 3, and 2, 2. So this not make the combination. So here we can write down 2, 9, 1, 6 is a, in case of prime factors, we have 2 times 2 and 3, 3, 6 times 3. Hope this one is clear to you. My face is not coming, so I am not going to, board is very small, so explanation is important, my face is not important. See, now we have to make the combination of three identical numbers, so 1, 2. These two numbers are not in a group of three. So by which number we have to divide? We have to divide by 4. 2, 9, 1, 6 must be divided 2 into 2, that is your 4. To make perfect cube, I am writing over here. Clear? So how? Therefore, we can say 2, 9, 1, 6 divided by 2 into 2. Now that is 4. How we find? We have, see, here we can write down 2 into 2 into. There is a 3 into 3 into 3, and then again we have to write down 3, 2 into 2. So what we have? 3 into 3 into 3, this 2 cancels each other. This is the total number, 3, 3 is a 9, 9, 3 is a 27. And again we have 27, so square, or we can say 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 3 is a 9. 9 into 9, 81, 81 into 9, 7, 2, 9. Or if you don't want to multiply this, so from, you can find out 2, 2 is 4, we remove this one, so what we have? 7, 2, 9. So it's a 7, 2, 9. This is the quotient, which is a perfect cube. Now we have to find out the cube root of 7, 2, 9. So cube root of 7, 2, 9 we can easily write down from here. It's a cube root of 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, that is your 3 into 3 equals to 9. Hope this one is clear to you. Now all of you try to solve question number 6 of this exercise and send me the solution. All of you try to complete size 5C in your fair copy. That's all for today. Thank you.